So yesterday I sat before you and I went, "I'm going to law school today." Today I sit before you and I go, "I'm going to law school." I'm Rebecca Fried and this is Ramblings with Rebecca, and I made the right choice. Yesterday was grand fun. Grand fun, I tell you. I went to Interstate Conflict and Humanitarian Law, and our poor lecturer was expecting us all to have read this mass amount of material because he had submitted, thinks, to the postgraduate office everything that he wanted uploaded to the course site. It was not all uploaded to the course site, so we walked in with a random pile of materials that had been uploaded in March 2013 and the course guide, which says very little other than introduction for the first week. So we're all sitting there in our blissful post cl or first class ignorance, and he's sitting there expecting us to have read, this amount on the legal definition of war, and understandings of war. We had read nothing, nothing. So we went around the room. There are 28 of us, I believe, from all over the place: Indonesia, Estonia, lots of Estonians. I don't know that I've ever seen so many Estonians in one place. It's really cool. I'm gonna learn about Estonia this year. I know very little about Estonia. It's gonna be grand. Anyway, Scot, Irish, English, Canadian, American. Lots of German, French, et cetera, Europe. Europe, lots of Europe. Anyway, and he said, "Okay, apparently no one has gotten any of the readings, so this is going to be perhaps briefer." And then, of course, we launched into a fantastic debate about the legal definition of war, because who needs to have done the readings to have a fun conversation? I'm not going to recap that now, because it was delightful and rambling. I know, go figure. A room in which I sat, in which there was conversation, was rambly. Anyway, so I'm gonna do a series on definitions of war and understandings and frameworks of war. We'll go through just war theory and how historically definitions and state understandings of war and warfare have changed, because they have changed quite a lot. And it may be that actually we're going back to more of a just war kind of framework than we had in the 19th century. Anyway, so I'm gonna do that series, but I also did want to take a pause just before I launch into excitedly rambling about whatever I, got from law school lecture and seminars, on whatever day, with no framework whatsoever, because on Thursdays I have three classes and I'm just gonna be freakishly excited, and I don't know how I'm gonna manage to have any kind of system to these, not that I have in the past. Anyway, but I wanted to pause, as I said, and see if there was anything else that you wanted to talk about that can be completely unrelated to law. Because I'm really excited. I super geeked out. I'm learning brand new things, and it's grand fun. I'm gonna randomly pick up on history. Do you know that I've never actually taken a proper history class? No joke. In high school, we moved at all the right times, so I had some kind of global issues or US pivotal moments kind of things, but they were all social studies and not full history. And so I know civil rights and women's suffrage in the US, and that's kind of as far as my formal training in history has gone. No European history, no, nothing. I mean, I know vague spatterings because I read a lot and I talk a lot and sometimes I listen a lot. So I know a bit of history, but I don't actually know history. Anyway, so we're gonna get that too as, we plot through all this legal stuff, because so many pivotal moments in law, are grand treaties that were all important. So I'm gonna be getting world history as I go through this, just by osmosis kind of thing, which is quite exciting. But before I blast you with random law and history, which you may or may not care about, I thought I should ask if there's anything you'd like to. I just did that in an incredibly rambling way. The title should warn you. Also, other side note, I have finally named the flat. Becca's bed and breakfast was cute, but I'm not exactly a traditionalist, as we know. So we are going to have Rebecca's Rooms of Requirement. Yes, because we had to do the geeky thing, okay? A Facebook page is coming, and everyone will be invited to come stay with me in my beautiful Rooms of Requirement in Edinburgh, should you care to do so. And if you have any ideas about the Rooms of Requirement and what you'd be requiring, let me know.